Welcome to Chef Hayley Wade's kitchen, and I have a lot of things laid out for you, but do not get fooled, this is not a recipe video. Today we're going to be trying weird kitchen items from Club Factory. Now you guys seem to love these videos, and I am a curious little girl who wants to know if these weird things work, so this is the perfect kind of video. I am actually going to make something while trying these things out, so let's begin. The first thing I'd like to try is this green silicone thing which you have to use for pouring items out of a huge vessel. So usually if you cook in a pan, suppose dal banai hai, this you are supposed to attach the green thing at the edge, and this is supposed to help you pour things out. So this is the apparatus for experiment number one. I'm going to be pouring half of our milk in this, and we shall try to pour it in this. Okay, it's pretty accurate, but as you can see, it's leaking from here, which actually defeats the purpose. Doesn't work, guys. Shit. So disappointing. Now, our next item is this blender. It's green in color. The packaging shows a really sleek and fancy looking dark blue shiny body, and this looks like a toy. I think this is battery operated. All we have to do is slide the top open and you can insert the batteries from here. First ingredient, we put our coffee in. Shit. Okay. Oh my god, it's splattering. Okay, I'll stick it close to the surface. Why is it so slow? Yeah, this is better. But it's working very slow inside. But to be fair, I don't see any lumps of coffee, man. Like, it looks like it's all done. So this, I could give it a side thumbs, because the pros that I see in this is that it's battery operated, to wireless AR, so it's very easy. The size, I find it very compact and nice, so that's another pro. But the cons are, the speed is inconsistent. When it is touching the bottom, like it's very close to the bottom, it is very slow. And the moment you bring it up, it's fast, but then it splatters. And pressing this is hard. Like, if I press it lightly, then it becomes very slow, and if I have to press it hard, my thumb is literally paining. So if only our first item would have worked, I would have actually used that to pour my coffee into the mug, but it was way too much of a disaster to try it. So we directly move on to our next item, which are these coffee design templates. Bought the whole pack. I don't think you have the option of buying individual ones. So I got, I think, more than 20 or 30 designs in the whole pack. Let's try it. No instructions came with this, so initially I thought ki ek hand se I'll hold it and from the other hand I'll sprinkle it. But I don't think that's how I've seen professional coffees. So I think I'll sift it like this on top of this. Luckily it fits perfectly on a normal sized cup. So I'll be using cocoa powder for this purpose. I don't think it's working. Because I can already see it getting dissolved inside. Okay, let's see. That looks bad. That looks very bad. Oh my god, this seems to work. So we have learned our lesson. Number one, I should not pour the coffee, mom should. Number two, this device works if you have a lot of foam on your coffee. If you're going to pour it directly on liquid coffee, this is going to just dissolve directly. But if you have a frothy coffee, foam on top, it will stay for like half a minute, because then it just starts dissolving. How to get foam on your coffee is blend it at very, very high speed and you will get minimal foam. And that was enough for my test, my experiment. So yeah, I do give this a thumbs up, because I feel fancy when I'm gonna have coffee like this, although I don't drink coffee. but hot chocolate, that might work. So we started off somewhere with a clean kitchen and here we are. This is what the scene is right now. That is why we now need this device. Usually this sponge part is the only thing that I clean utensils with, but I don't like it. I don't like my hands to get soapy and to get in touch with the food that was in the utensils for a long time. So I ordered this thing. You actually have to pour the cleaning liquid here with water and then I think you've got to squeeze this and then you can clean it. Let's see if it works and if it was worth the money. So here we go. This is pure liquid. I'll be dissolving it with water later on. Okay, I think that's enough. So the sponge hasn't gotten wet at all. In fact, it's leaking from the back, if anything. This device did not come with instructions, so I'm just making guesses with every step. And I'll keep pressing this in the hope that the sponge will get wet. Yeah, see, this is the hole inside. So liquid is coming out of this. I have wet it. Okay, this seems to work, but what about the turns? Okay, this is fitting in it. So even in the crevices, the sponge seems to fit. And I can see soap. I did not touch that soap to this at all. So yeah, see? Bubbles to hai. So don't get fooled. It did work, but the whole point of using that device is to not get our hands, I won't say dirty because it's not dirty, but where the device leaks. So my hands are all soapy right now and that's what I was thinking, ki if my hands are to get soapy, why would I use that device? I would just use the scrub directly. So that is why even though it worked and I got happy in the moment, I'll give this a thumbs down because I want my hands dry. That was why I bought the device. So we finally over coffee and we have random things to test in the end. The first thing are these jar Ziploc bags. Are these Ziploc? I think these are Ziploc. When you put something in these are supposed to give the illusion that these are actually in a jar. And I think these are pretty cool. So I'm going to put some walnuts in this and see how it looks. So I'm going to open this. Okay, this is just like a Ziploc. I'm going to put the nuts inside. It's not that transparent actually. I'm going to shut this now. And this is what it looks like. So this is not any different from a normal Ziploc bag at all in functionality, but it looks damn cool, man. Like the fact that it's not completely transparent, I think that adds to the aesthetic that it's in a jar, and it does look pretty cool, and it does give a little bit of illusion that it is in a jar. So I say if you put it on display or if this is how you keep it in the fridge, I think it's more appealing and I give this a thumbs up. I think this is one of my most favorite things from this whole experimenting video. So our last item is this hand towel. I don't know what was I thinking when I ordered this because I'm not sure if this is value for money. But if you hang this in your kitchen, then it should hold its shape. I mean, that's the whole point of getting this, right? And it does not do that. But if you go in terms of quality and if it absorbs water, it does. For functionality, I give this a thumbs up. But do I find it value for money? Not really. And does this really hold its shape? Not really. So that is why overall, I give this a thumbs down. So this was it for me trying weird kitchen items from Club Factory. Although my kitchen is a mess, I enjoy doing this and I hope I helped you save some money on items which looked lucrative but don't really perform. Overall, there wasn't a lot of success in this video, but it was worth a try. So if you want me to try any other items from any other genre or maybe kitchen itself, then make sure to DM the link to me on my Instagram account. It is @Hailey_Ved and I'll try them in the next video. Until then, goodbye.